Hi, I'm Jim Covington. Today is January 19th, 2017. I'd like to welcome you to this week's issue of ISBA Statehouse Review. The General Assembly will be in session next week, starting committee work. Five bills have been introduced that I think you might find of some interest. They have to be referred to a substantive committee, but they've just been introduced. The first one amends the Illinois Vehicle Code, House Bill 2221, introduced by Representative Jahan Gordon Booth from Peoria. And it makes two changes to current law in the reporting of court supervision to the Secretary of State's office. Under current law, if a driver is under 21 and commits a serious traffic offense under the code or a similar local ordinance, that disposition of supervision must be reported to the Secretary of State's office. This requires it for drivers of any age. The second change amends the time which clerks must refer reports of supervision to the Secretary of State's office. Under current law, it's within 5 days. This will require immediate notification to the Secretary of State of a disposition of court supervision for traffic offenses, some of which are already exempted under current law. The next bill amends the Landlord-Tenant Act. It's House Bill 471, introduced by Representative LaShawn Ford from Chicago. It allows a tenant to recover all the rent payable from the time the lease is entered into until the tenant vacates the premises with two conditions. If a landlord enters into a lease with a tenant after receiving notice of a foreclosure action, and two, the tenant later is required to vacate the premises as a result of that foreclosure action. The next bill creates the Value After Rehabilitation Appraisal Act. It's a House Bill 367. Introduced by Representative LaShawn Ford, and it provides an appraisal that takes value into account after rehabilitation for any program administered by the state that requires an appraisal to be formed on real estate. You must account for that value. This kind of appraisal must be accepted to the extent that any other appraisal methods for real estate sales and finance are accepted. Obviously, if it's prohibited by federal law or regulation, this doesn't apply, and that bill has just been introduced. House Bill 280 amends the Illinois Domestic Violence Act. It's introduced by Representative Marty Moylan from Des Plaines, and it allows a petition for an order of protection to be filed by the state's attorney on behalf of a person who has been abused by a family or household member. The court may, on its own motion, on behalf of a person who has been abused by a family or household member, issue an order of protection thereafter. It also links in the duration of a plenary order of protection in a criminal case to no longer than 10 years after sentence completion, rather than the current law of 2 years. The final bill I'd like to talk to you about amends the mortgage foreclosure article of the Code of Civil Procedure and makes substantial changes in that process. It's Senate Bill 192, introduced by Senator Pam Althoff from Crystal Lake. And it provides that a mortgagee establishes a prima facie case for foreclosure once the following evidence has been offered and admitted. One, the mortgage at issue in the case, and two, the note at issue in the case. The mortgagee is not required to present further evidence to establish a prima facie case of foreclosure. Once a prima facie case of foreclosure has been established by the mortgagee, the burden of proof and of presenting evidence shifts to the mortgagor to prove the amount owed on the note payment and any affirmative defense the mortgagor claims. Failure of the mortgagor to present evidence of the amount owed on the note constitutes a waiver of that issue, regardless of any contrary pleadings, and the mortgagee thereafter has the burden of presenting evidence on the amount due on the note. Finally, if the burden of presenting evidence regarding the amount owed on the note shifts back to the mortgagee because of the mortgagor's failure to present this evidence, the amount owed on the note must be proven by affidavit. If the mortgagor presents evidence of the amount owed on the note, the mortgagee may present evidence in rebuttal, and this rebuttal evidence must be taken in open court. Thank you for listening, and we'll see you next week.